Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Rebecca and today we'll be doing a restorative yoga practice against the wall. So in restorative yoga, we hold the poses for around 15 minutes. So we want to make very little effort. And to assist us with doing this, we can use props, and in this case we're going to use the wall. Now, restorative yoga is about being still and quiet. And I would recommend having at least two blankets and your mat for some comfort and ease while you're in the postures. I would also recommend making sure that you have a few layers of clothes for warmth. And as we're against the wall, I'd also recommend having some thick socks for the comfort of your feet as they are against the wall. Okay, so we're going to start in Viparita Karani, or legs up the wall. So if you come with your hip touching the wall, your knees bent, and then we'll just come down, bring the torso down onto the floor, your buttocks are against the wall, and then just turn yourself to the side so that you're on your back, your buttocks are against the wall, and have your feet straight up the wall. You can perhaps bring a gentle bend in the knees, whatever is more comfortable to you. You might want your feet exactly together, or a little bit apart. You can either have your hands resting at the tops of the thighs, or you might want to take them out to a T or quite wide out to the side. When you have found your comfortable version of this asana, this posture, just relax, release, and let go. And then we'll just slowly start to transition from this pose. We'll come into reclined figure four. So if you just bend your right leg and allow your ankle to rest just above the knee, and then you can either keep your leg straight or you can bend at the knee. This is a bit intense. If you want to keep the knee bent, you can come a bit further away from the wall so that the sole of the foot presses against the wall, and then cross. Allow the ankle to rest just above the knee. And you can either have your arms resting out to the side, or you might like to have the palms resting on the thighs for a bit more support. You choose the best version for yourself. And then we'll just slowly transition from one side to the other. So straighten out the leg. It's either going straight up the wall or it might be bent with the sole of the foot resting against the wall. And then just bend the left knee. Allow the left ankle to rest just above the right knee. And you can allow your hands again to rest against the upper thighs. And then we'll just start to transition out of the posture. So bringing the left leg back to the wall. If you moved away from the wall, slowly start to come back closer so that the buttocks rest against the wall. And then we'll come into reclined Baddha Konasana, reclined cobbler's pose. So bringing the knees bent and the soles of the feet together. You can have a longer diamond or shorter so that the heels can be closer to the buttocks. And again, you can allow the arms to rest out to the side, or you might want to support the thighs just above the knees, finding the version that's most comfortable for you, that you can just rest for a while. And then we'll slowly start to transition out of this posture. Gently use the hands to bring the knees back together. And you can either complete the practice in Viparita Karani, legs up the wall, or you might want to bring your feet down onto the wall and then roll back down to one side and then slowly transition yourself into Shavasana, lying on the floor with the feet apart, the hands a bit away from the body, the palms facing the sky. Allow time for the integration of this practice in Shavasana. And then just slowly start to lengthen your breath, bringing gentle movements to the fingers and the toes, the hands and the feet, arms and legs. You might want to stretch out long. Maybe you want to hug in. And then with your legs bent, gently rolling over to one side, to a fetal position. Just pause here a moment. And then gently push yourself up with your hands. Coming back to a comfortable seated position. Bringing your hands into prayer position. And thank you for joining me in this restorative yoga practice today. Namaste.
Follow this link to the Emerald Alignment, which is a 4-minute energy field alignment to complete the integration of this yoga practice. There are links below for more information. If you enjoyed this video, please click on the like button and subscribe to the channel.